Up next, a report on the portrayal of women in Bollywood.
Shikar?
नीचे देख
वैसे मेरी फिल्म में तुम्हें स्विमिंग कॉस्ट्यूम पहनना पड़ेगा
क्यों
क्योंकि मेरी फिल्म डूबनी नहीं चाहिए ना बेबी
एंड दैट हैज बीन वन ऑफ बॉलीवुड्स फेवरेट फॉर्मूला
क्या देख रहे हो
तुम्हारी लिपस्टिक
शिकार माल आइटम और इवन तंदूरी चिकन
मैं तो तंदूरी मुर्गी
Sexual innuendos, pepper filmy numbers, in the name of creative freedom. With Cross riding on a single project, a plunging neckline, some pelvic thrusts, and a catchy tune often bear the onus of catching eyeballs.
Papa ka prayashit kar
le. Lekin usse pehle, pap to kar le.
It's perfectly possible for a completely naked person to look beautiful and for a fully clothed person to look vulgar because voyeuristic camera angles vulgar lyrics they do not celebrate a woman's sensuality they commodify her
but this questionable representation of women is not new to Bollywood from bands only being sexual creatures to item songs before they had been termed so they've all been a regular feature But should a filmmaker be held responsible for portrayal of women in what are but works of fiction?
It's becoming now a certain kind of wave to actually blame the industry, cinema, for various crimes that happen in society. Why not blame upbringing, lack of laws, and lack of law implementation? I think these various reasons. Are the reasons why there is any kind of misogyny or any kind of thinking that is wrong?
Item numbers don't cause rape, we know that. But there has to be a certain change fundamentally in the way we treat women. And I think this can be achieved even by having on the regulatory body a bit more representation of women or men who are gender sensitive.
Then you can't change the girl. Change the girl.
While cinema and works of fiction can't be blindly held accountable for attitude towards women at large, but can it, as a medium with the power and scope of reaching millions, play a significant role in not commodifying women out of context? Entertainment Bureau, CNN IBN.